So here at Controlsoft, we started life as primarily a systems integrator, and over the last few years we've added a number of competencies here. So we've moved from just traditional PLC and SCADA programming. On top of that, we moved into robotics, machine design. We've also added a software team here, so we do the .NET high-end applications. And we feel that putting all those competencies together gives us a total package offering that not many in the marketplace offer. Controlsoft and KUKA's goals align quite well in that Controlsoft can deliver the service, but we rely on KUKA for support, for the technology, and also tools like the simulation packages. So we found those very valuable working with KUKA, where we can go and do a simulation with a customer and get buy-in much earlier in the process. And that really adds synergies where the KUKA platform with Controlsoft expertise delivers a total solution for our customers.
So syringe handling is extremely difficult and, well, it's hard to achieve. There's nobody that's doing it that we can find in the way that we're doing it. So based on simulation, so digital twinning and concept designs in the 3D and simulated world, we were able to build our machine and experiment which models of robot would have the correct speed, the correct reach, payload requirements, repeatability and reliability. And the AGILUS ticked all those boxes. It's specifically built for this purpose. There is, I think, many opportunities to promote this particular machine. It can be made modular, you know, it can be customized, modified, you know, it's a 3D design that can be added to, you know, to suit whatever the customer needs. But specifically in syringe handling, I think it's a very unique method. We can't see anybody else doing it like this. So I think we have a cornered niche that nobody else has a solution for right now.
I think people are going to automate anything they can possibly automate. So the only barrier will be when the cost is effective. I think companies will, over the next few years, really look at robotics to replace manual labour, especially in high-value centres like Ireland and mainland Europe. We're not a cheap labour workforce, so we should be moving that labour to the more expertise jobs and letting the robots do the manual task. And I think people are so used to now having like phones and tablets where you're swiping stuff quickly, the acceptance of technology has moved quite a lot in the last few years. There's no more fear factor around having that in your business. There will be a shift towards robotics. I think we've seen that already. I think the driving factor for that will be a couple. Obviously, the cost of labor is a big factor. I think people working in close proximity after COVID is another factor that's going to drive this. And basically the higher quality that we can achieve with robots, the repeatability. Some companies would have looked at automation as either being scary or our process is too difficult to automate. I think now if we look at what's been automated out there, there's very few tasks out there that really can't be automated. And I think the companies who drive automation through their business will be the successful ones.
Industrial intelligence.